Everybody shackling, everybody shackling me to this chair to cast this tournament. D2E DTS versus .exe is our last game of the evening. We've been casting EG all night and decided, you know what, the winds of change must be blowing past this point so we can actually have some new teams. But we are going to keep with one team, which I've only seen one time tonight. So that's EXE just coming off their, spoiler alert, loss in their last game. They will now be going up against DTS, a very, very hard team, definitely. A team which is also incapable of loading up into the game. And, of course, a person who is incapable of getting to the point. So I'm going to throw it for the person who generally does do that for me, my co-commentator, Wagamaga from Infused Man. Welcome, 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 welcome to the commentary box.
Thank you, and we see the dire victory. Oh, okay, that was quick.
Game is over, EXE wins.
All right.
It's because we got so many spectators. For some reason, D2E decided to have four admins in here and all their friends, and then three different streamers and then all their friends. And that's who's inside the game right now.
So. Sounds legit. I'm really happy to see Goblin. I didn't know he was playing in the new TTS lineup. And he's a really funny guy. He came up to me when we were in Kiev on the ICSC9 event. Mm-hmm. And he came up to me, stood behind me, watching me while we were playing a little bit. And then he said, hi, man. I really like that you play my hero in official matches. I'm like, okay, thanks, but who? And then he was like, I'm Goblin. Oh, nice. So he was referring to Goblin Techies, a hero he loves. So, yeah, he's a really cool guy. I'm happy to see him play again.
Mm-hmm. Why is A to D trying to spell out your name? Why is it spelled out? Is it Wagamama? Is it Wagamama?
Wag-a-mama.
Yeah, I'm right. Why is he spelling it out for me? It's not as though like we're going to go back in the whole debate. Is it Kurikai or is it Kuronity or is it whatever the frickin' hell is? It's not Kuronity,
honestly. It's Kiki.
It's Kuro. Good times. Good times. Great mispronunciations. Join Dota. It's now going to be our new slogan. It's going to be great.
Yeah. Man, I'm so happy now after my little visit to the kitchen. I found some crackers with cheese. That's all I have to eat.
That's really great for you, man. Crackers and cheese. Brought up in a prison. You're allowed to eat like bread and water, and every now and then your mama would treat you with cheese.
That's why casting from a prison.
That's no casting from a prison. I'm pretty sure you get a net line into a prison. if I get arrested for some of the stuff I say on the stream, I get put on a prison. I'm like, yeah, just give me a studio.
No problem.
Put me in an isolation cell. I'm pretty sure at least then nobody else will hear me. It'll be great. we need a soundproof room. The one with the white walls will do. I can cast in that. Now I've got this image of an insane person casting from an insane ward. What is your background? A white wall. Hang on, my background's a white wall. Hang on, I'm not in an insane ward.
Why are the bars on your window, man?
They're to keep people out.
It's stylish in Germany right now. It's trend.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. They're something like barring your friends from entering. It's great. It's like having your own firewall. It works, man. It works. I love this. And now it's pronounced Pepe. Pepe? Pepe?
Pepe? Pepe?
Mm. Pepe? Is it Pepe? 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 It's Pepe. Mm. Like Pepper. Pepe. Get a little bit easier on the nose. Let's have a look at our game after that bit of a stall up, because obviously the game didn't load up. We generally will fill that time with complete nonsense. And I'm pretty sure you got complete nonsense then. So we deliver what we promised. Over towards the Radiant side, DTS will be playing there. Piggy! We'll be playing there. I'm actually going to let you run through the rest of this DTS lineup. Son of a gamer. All right, you can run through the lineup after we go through our banning stage, which is slightly unusual at this point because Animage and Prophet, standard, from PGG, Venno and Rasta are the bans out from Move, which now means that Broodmother as well as Nightstalker both get through the pool as well as a Lich. A lot of options. And Broodmother is going to be the first pick because they have first pick. So Move will take the Brood again.
Yeah. That's a very open pool. And we still see the Chen should be mentioned. That hero is also something that you might see banned in the first phase sometimes, but he also found his way through.
I did not say Wagga Magga in the intro.
Only like 90% of the times, yeah.
Really? Wagga Magga?
When you get stressed, you say Wagga Magga.
Really? Mm-hmm. Cool. It's like I don't even notice I'm saying that. It's like when I try and call Ask Art and I call him Art Style. I'm like, I don't hear me say that. It's just, I don't know what you guys are on about. Like, you're all nuts. I think you're all nuts.
Nah, I'm right. You 5,000 people, you're wrong.
Exactly. Exactly.
That's good. Fight the power, Toby.
The caster is always right. It's like the woman in every relationship. Get it right.
Are they going to go for the... Nah. Are they going for the...
They'll take NS. They didn't take
NS.
That's
very surprising. And they might go for... Neither team going for NS yet.
Well, I kind of know exactly why they've taken up VS as well as Beastmaster. It's best to say to PGG, don't you dare take Enigma.
And
don't even
also,
think about it.
Also, those heroes are both very good at killing the Brood, so it's a nice way to both build a nice lineup, prevent one pick, and actually making it a bit harder to kill the Brood.
Mm-hmm. I just reminded too for the guys who are actually asking, because obviously we've been casting almost nothing but the defense for the past, I don't know, however many days. This is a different tournament. This is D2E. It's a tournament which is being organized by the French boys. So they've organized this up, and 2K Euro. 2K Euro is up for grabs from this tournament. So I just thought I'd give everyone a bit of an update for it all. And
here comes the Enigma ban, so even though they picked those heroes.
Why?
I'm surprised.
And I'm really surprised too, because you've got a Windrunner who's already at your side, unless they're just thinking about a neutraler. Considering DTS banned Chen, there is no other neutraler. On the bright side, we're going to see a lot more people in the lanes.
Usually it speaks for more action.
Mm-hmm. Yay!
Action!
I like more action.
And we see Sanking again, by the way. That's nice.
Mm-hmm.
I'm
just happy Windrunner's here because everybody's shackling, everybody's shackling.
You're happy to see Windrunner. Well, you always get to see Windrunner, don't you?
It's true. She's either in the ban pool or in the picks. She never avoids either.
She's not very often banned, though. It's like maybe in the second phase.
Yeah.
I don't see many teams banning her in the first phase. It's like, meh.
Oh.
And they're going Aura Strats. Hardcore.
Ooh. Okay.
You like that, bro. I forgot that.
I don't even feel my toes anymore. That could also be a separate problem. but Drow Ranger coming up. I really like this lineup from the Dire. Yeah, you're right. It's like so many aura stacks they've got while still having stuns that go through BKB. We've got silence. We've got slows. We've got negative armor. We've got focus stuns, one of them. From VS, and I wouldn't be surprised even if with this lineup they grab something along the lines of like a Witch Doctor or someone else that can throw out another stun or CM. I like the Witch Doctor a little bit more though.
They do definitely need another ranged hero, because if you want to get full benefit from an Aura Strat, especially when it's with a Drow Ranger, you want to put in one more ranged hero. Usually you go for four ranged heroes and one melee, which is Rexxar. But they already have the Broodmother, so now definitely a range hero. But first, we really need to see what Radiant is going for. Yeah, and Dire doesn't have very much anti-push. They have, like, the Axis of Rexxar, and that's it.
Well, DTS doesn't really have a lot of pushing power themselves. If they grab themselves a Krob, then yeah. They're finally going to take the NS, so they're going to say, well, we can gank. You can push, we can gank. But even then, like, NS... I'm not quite sure about that. If NS runs in there, if he gets himself silenced up, then he's going to lose his voice, he's going to lose his own silence. It's going to be almost like the battle of who can fire off their ability beforehand. And I believe Drow will win that because hers is more of an AoE. It's not a focused target, so her range should just be that little bit longer. And NS could find himself well in over his head.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. I think that the Nice Talker kind of... He had his chance to be in this game, but now... I don't know. It doesn't seem like he will be very, very effective in this game. But then again, you never know what happens. It could be a massive Roman gank game and Nightstalker going, holy shit. Can happen. So I'm just surprised to see him picked.
I wonder where we might go from here as well. If we, well, tied under for the Dire.
So they didn't go for a wrench here. They decided to go for just one more team fight setup. And that's kind of smart, though, because they did need more team fight capability.
Yeah, Tide's kind of like the king of that.
Yeah, pretty much.
And who are we going to see out as the last one for DTS? That's going to be my question. And I don't know why I'm niggling towards Nakes. But Nakes, for me, I think might actually work right now.
I'm just thinking about
Lifesteal and what can hold up against. And if he jumps himself inside, jumps out, the spiraling push will stop. You can almost jump himself inside the boar if you want to. The choices are his.
I think the Nakes could definitely work, and they get some gruesome slows with Nightstalker and Nakes in the same lineup.
Mm-hmm.
Not to forget, they have to have something with decent DPS against this lineup. They need to bring down the Broodmother, even though she has a BKB. Oh, they decide to go for AA.
This is going to be really hard for them if they don't get a Saturn in S.
AA is very good with Nightstalker, though, so it kind of makes sense, but it's going to be hard for the Radiant, I think, judging by lineups.
They don't really, and this is a problem which I see coming out of a lot of lineups which are picked over the last couple of weeks.
No,
there's no real DPS.
Yeah,
that comes out from that lineup. Like, sure, you're going to stop the regeneration if you can bring him low enough, you can shatter him, but you need to bring him low enough. And so many times you see Windrunner ending up in the position where she needs to buy like an MKB to deal off the damage because no one else is going to do it. But Windrunner can't out damage a Drow Ranger. It's not possible.
No. And the thing is, even though they don't have very much DPS, and look at it again, they don't have that much push either. So they have really good defense, of course. Their lineup is very good for defending push, and that's probably because they face a first big Broodmother. You get pretty defensive in your pick, in your mindset. But they are lacking both DPS and push, which can be a threat to them.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so it looks like we're just waiting for one player from DTS, Vigos, who has the name EKV under it. Actually, while we're here, man, do you want to actually run through the players? I don't know why I just said actually like five times in like a couple of seconds. Oh, it's not back. I'm not doing that again. Would you mind ever so kindly going through the teams?
Oh, yeah.
Without me saying that word.
Yeah, I was just waiting for to see how would you throw it. So in DTS, we have PGG, who is going to play the Windrunner, and most likely going to run top lane. And we have Vigos having problems, therefore he has no hero, while everyone else does. Goblin, who is such a cool guy, is going to play the AA. That makes sense, actually. And who is playing Nightstalker?
I do not know. Are you next?
I don't know who he is, but his name is DTS Aya Nikes. Okay.
We have
Dark Angel.
I'm now just checking the join Dota news, which will then link me to what I need to find.
Yes, please check. Right. And yes.
I thought you were going to keep on going.
So. yeah, I'm just looking at the chat. Someone was spamming EKV is Equilibrium. Yeah, and Equilibrium is Vigos. And on the other team, as we saw them in...
All right, so they got Blow Your Brain and Always Want to Fly. Are there other options? So I'm assuming it's Always Want to Fly because he's generally playing with them. But it could be Blow Your Brain, because Blow Your Brain does like to play that aggressive. Oh, actually, then again, the same way.
All right. And, wow, we see a really early smoke, by the way, on the Dire team. Never mind saying who is who right now. And they have Basilius. This looks like a Roshan go. Basilius and, I don't know, they have too many salves. This is a Roshan go.
Ballsy.
Are they going to scout it?
No one's moving anywhere.
Having troubles with one computer early, they might not be even thinking about the Roshan right now. And their lineup isn't too obvious that it's a Roshan strat either. It's pretty hidden. So we'll see what happens here. I think they're going to get a free Roshan kill. That's obviously huge. Everyone is going to be level 2.5.
Lovely amount of damage they're getting too. You got the precision aura from Dro Ranger. She is just like wanting to right-click the living crap out of that. And we got this. So it's a wave of terror. So it's negative armor. They're combining, and now Rice has to move himself back. So whenever you go level 1 Roshan, kids and girls and boys, I don't know why I use those descriptive terms. you just tag team the damage. Pop off a salve when you move back if you're the one taking too much damage, and then you're ready to go. And it gives you 200 gold for everybody from the get-go of the game. The only downside is you'll be a little bit late into your lanes. On the upside, however, you will be a full level above everybody else on the map.
Oh, yeah. One thing they... This is probably not something they have done before and tried. This is probably something they made up on the spot because Tide has skilled Gush, but when Broodmother skilled Net, so he always had his spell block ready.
Mm-hmm.
So the Gush was actually pointless.
Yeah, because
Never mind that. They did get the Roshan, and they are now 1.5 levels ahead of everyone else in the entire game, and that's pretty huge.
Yeah, it is, man. That's going to make it really hard, especially on this bottom lane. You've already got Stun as well as Wave of Terror. You got 2 levels up on the Dro range. She's got Cold as well as Precision. And that's going to give extra damage to not only Dro, but also to the VS. And I'm wondering, too, if we're going to see that Vengeance Aura come up pretty early on, too. So Dro range, you can just right-click that SK back completely from the line. And SK's also caught in the wrong lane. He was expecting Brood to be on the bottom lane.
Oh, yeah. They got the lanes completely as they want as well, and they have Aegis on the Brood, so even though she's up against 3 heroes, she's going to be perfectly fine.
Mm-hmm.
And she almost has level 3 when everyone else is level 1, and when she just sends those Broodlings, it's going to be horrible for the Night Stalker and his supporters.
Mm-hmm.
And we see a disconnect from Blood Angel, so let's see what happens. They have some issue, can't see it. The health bars.
Hey, man, can you check out what's happening with Tidehunter? Because that looks like a frying pan.
With what? With who?
Look down at Tidehunter next to his axe, next to his anchor. There's a little thing. It looks like a frying pan, but then it's not. I know, it's his chains.
Yeah, it's the chains of the thing, but it looks like they are coming up from below the ground.
Yeah,
to me.
I don't know why I thought like Tide was cooking fish or something.
That would be wrong.
Yeah.
He's not a cannibal, is he? Well, he is, I guess.
I do not know.
He always says he can eat plankton or whatever.
Hey, plankton. Plankton, that's a bit deceiving, bro. Oh, shout out to the New Zealanders if you're currently tuning in. Because only they will... anyone from Australia or New Zealand should get that joke. Everyone else, I apologize. You need to look up for like a New Zealand comic which had a blue whale in it. And it's, yeah. I would explain the comic, but it's really not as funny if you've explained it. You got to watch it because it's just hilarious. Yeah. Anyway, we do have a couple of heroes that are connecting back in again. That's because they could not see the health bars. So, easy way of fixing that is basically just restarting. Makes life very, very easy.
Yeah, it should be fine now. And they are starting.
I also just realized that my overlay is not showing up. My apologies for this. We will just... I don't know why it's not turning up on the stream. I've been updating it, but yeah, it wasn't turning up. So I just got to turn that off, and then you can see it again. Which works out nicely for everybody who's tuning in, because then they actually know what the hell's going on. Now, PGG's... What the hell happened to PGG in the middle lane? He's lucky to get a regen rune. Well, actually, not lucky. He knew where it was because of his ward. But that's, yeah.
Here we see a foo.
A foo?
A foo. Yeah, Vigos is not too happy on his lane. He's just writing some little abbreviations on the all chat. He's probably unhappy with the Tide who's running around with a clarity potion and Dust of Appearance, and he really wants a kill on the Sand King.
I think generally he's supposed to separate those two letters so they become two words, is the word he's currently searching for, which is F-U.
Yeah. I know. I just didn't want to say it.
Really?
Thanks for clearing that up.
I'm here for all those people out there who just need clarification.
Oh, yeah. And AA is actually coming down to help that poor Sand King a little bit, so the Tide isn't being evil to him.
Yeah. SK just realized he can't get close enough. Also, yeah. Let's actually just check out our farm as well. Actually, here at Invis, it's just PGG. Sorry, it's PGG. By the way, I can't say PGG softly.
You have to look at the gold graph. It looks too funny.
It doesn't even start at zero. It just starts at 1500.
That's so funny. It's like, no, we start down here. You start up there. Okay.
So that's what happens when Roshan is killed early on. It's just insta gold. It's accurate. It's 100% accurate.
It is true.
It just looks like a massively unfair advantage. Maybe it's going to start at the 0 second mark. But then again, you can't end any income during that time. So what's the point, apart from Roshan? All right, cool. I can go with this. TP coming towards the top lane. It's going to become a trial lane on top. SK leaves. So finally, we're going to see the lane swap up.
Wow.
And SK's going to get some levels up on top.
Yeah, Night Stalker is TPing down. And yeah, this is big rotation. And Tide,
they're going to go on AA via stun and arrow. Yeah, fire dead. One, fire two, and out they go, the first blood. Giving a Drow Ranger.
Not a good start for the new tri lane to be. And Harosh coming out.
Well, they knew that was going to happen anyway. They knew if you rotate the lane, sure it's going to work out better for you, but they're going to get pushed out, or they're going to give too much farm towards the Broodmother, and that's something which none of those heroes could deal with.
Yeah, I think the fact is that Sand King is a very good hero against Broodmother, but he is behind in levels now. She's almost level 6, and he is not even close to his level 5 yet. Mm-hmm. So I think that's not even going to be an easy lane for him. He has 0 points in his Caustic Finale as well, so... Mm-hmm. It's going to be hard.
I also just realized, too, like Nightstalker, once he gets the night time, it's going to be a little bit easier for him. But moving on that bottom lane is going to be impossible because Tide is down there. What's up?
They're setting up.
Coming in from behind. Beastmaster Roar, VS stun, ensures the kill. PGG dead in the middle lane. And then back on the bottom lane, Drow Ranger might get called out. Nightstalker with a great body block here. It will be enough to pop off that cold feet. It's going to be the death of Drow Ranger. Should be the death of Drow Ranger. Is the death of Drow Ranger. That was pretty close, though, and Ganked held on to his Gush. I'm surprised. I thought he might have even just thrown on the Nightstalker, so he couldn't, in case Drow Ranger did have that small opportunity to get out. But he held on to it. Maybe Ganked just wants some levels. You can't gank with that levels.
And we see Broodmother has bought up her emo ring, and it's on the way. Or is it? No, it's not on the way. It's in her stash. Chicken is on other more important missions. But once she has it and that Aegis, she's going to be able to put so much pressure on this poor Sand King. Mm-hmm. I'm curious to see if they will send up a sentry ward as well to her lane. It would be so good for her. Bottom lane is the most interesting lane now, though. They have the urn on Nightstalker, so if they kill one, they will be quite good for killing another.
Mm-hmm. The question is if they can.
Yeah, already power treads on the Drow Ranger, so it's going to be hard.
Keeping him on strength treads. I was interested to see if we're going to see a poor man shield out from Drow Ranger, because I know it's a good early item, especially if you're in a lane. Now, obviously, there's a tri lane, and she can buy that from the side shop, the stout shield, to finish it off. And just to have that just in case, or to reduce it down so DDS have a lot harder time trying to kill off EXE.
Yeah. It's an option, but then again, she could just leave them be and go straight for a more important early game item. She might even go for a really early BKB this game.
Oh, sentry. Dust, SK, Burrow strikes himself away. Is there an anchor smash? Yes, there is. And Tide, with the real anchor, kills the Dolph.
This is going to be a problem for the top lane tower. And they're just staying down there, supporting their Nightstalker. I don't even know if they want to put someone up there.
PGG is coming in the bottom lane, looking for a kill on the win on the Drow Ranger. Shackle can't latch. Everyone's not Shackle, and Drow's now currently getting frosted. Cold feeded up. 4 heroes for DTS to take that out. And VS and Beastmaster coming down. They realize a lot of spells are now being popped. Axes will fly. Nightstalker runs up towards the high ground. Got to be really careful when VS still has his stun there.
Yeah. VS might have been in a position to stun that guy.
PGG! Mid lane! Stun will follow! Gush might even hold it! He's gonna hold it! She has no mana for it, so he's gonna hold it.
Yeah, this is the power from their combination heroes. They have such a strong pick-off lineup. And they do have Tide to just equalize that team fight, as well as Brood to just stand and push. I would say that...
Yes, just Brood lost the Aegis.
Oh, yeah, she did.
SK with the Epicenter Mage to kill off the Broodmother. But the funny thing is, the Aegis can be reclaimed in a couple of minutes' time anyway.
And now
there's
dropped.
There's the Dust and Gushed and Anchored, and Tide gets another kill.
Yeah, this is why it's such a hard lane to hold now with... Just that Aegis on Broodmother early game, I mean, it's already hard enough to lane against Broodmother early game. And to lane against her underleveled and against Aegis, it's not a fair chance.
We missed a death in the bottom lane, so we do have two own charges now on the Nightstalker as the Drow Ranger who died back next to the tier 1 tower on the bottom.
Yeah.
But
she's still pretty happy. I mean, she has her power treads up since pretty early. Even though Nightstalker is getting a little bit of momentum now, I mean, she does have the gold from that early Roshan and some good lane control in the early phase. Mm-hmm. But they need to get some towers and start rotating a little bit so Drow can get up on the top lane later. That would be exactly what they want. A mid lane. As soon as Rex has his ulti ready, he's going for a new gang, and sadly this time he didn't get it.
Yes, it shouldn't be too hard to do, though, with the VS now also up at level 6. So that swap will now come into play. If PGG comes even a hair too close, the swap, and then you got the double stunning with the Beastmaster Roar and the Magic Missile. That's enough to get any kill. PGG can't run from that.
He
can try, but it's not going to work.
Lich is actually pretty close to his level 6, and once he got that, he's a big, 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 big ganker.
Now they're going to go to the bottom gang, and the Ravage! Tide is level 6! Drow will turn around, the anchor smash, they get the kill on Lich, while you are not getting your level 6 anytime soon.
Yeah, he wants to be the only one who has the level 6 of them. And,
Selfish!
It's so worth it, and now they're going, they know the Tide ulti is on cooldown, and they're going in, but... Can Drow deal the damage?
Drow's trying to. PGG is running through. This could be damaging. The silence now going on PGG. But Nightstalker, negative earn. That'll be enough to kill if he can get one last hit. The Anchor Smash is there. Power shot. But there's the Void out from Nightstalker. And Tide retreats back to the Tier 2 tower. Great player here from DTS.
But Rexar is behind them and he wants to get out of there.
Yeah, you should not be there, Rexar. You should not be there. He's fighting. He's going to roar this when they line themselves up. PGG has himself a power shot if he wants to use it. And there's the urn and power shot. That's a kill.
He goes down.
No stick. Okay, he's dead.
It's still too much. And Venge is now also going in, but they are out of mana. They're like, no, we killed so much already. Stop coming.
PGG. PGG stops a no man.
Yeah.
He stops for a tower, however.
This is such a good start for a Nightstalker now, though, considering the bad start early on. They are now getting some nice action, lots of kills, and his earn charge is ticking up. Mm-hmm. So he's been in 6 kills in 10 minutes. That's pretty good. I mean, that's a normal good game for a Nightstalker. And after the Roshan kill, I think you can't ask for more.
Yeah. It's been really impressive for DTS. Let's check out our goal graph, see where it's been going. And actually, it's still in the way of the Dire, and I'm not surprised with the Broodmother on the field. But holding it at 2k, even though now it's 6-6, and a lot of the later kills are worth so much more money because you get so much more from it. Keeping it 6-6 and still 2k advantage in favor of the Dire side, still looking good for the Zijomons. In the meantime, bottom lane, Burrow Strike.
Oh, wow.
They might be thinking about the Epicenter. Gang's going to come through, but he has it. No Ravage right now, but he's just trying to make him go, "Why, I have a Ravage," but no, he doesn't. He's still at 21
thing.
Seconds.
Same thing on Vigos, he did not have mana to follow up his stun with an ulti there, else he might have done it. And he's now bottling up, trying to get it. And mid, we see many heroes standing mid.
Yeah, NS, AA. AA is actually level 6 now too, so keep your eyes open for that ultimate. In the meantime though, I think Broodmother's looking for an opening on the top.
Radiance bottom top. Yeah, we see the... All heroes
Burrow,
are mid or top.
Epicenter, Ravage cancels it! At the last moment! And the Dust! Great shot from PGG, but it's not going to be enough. AA, in the meantime, we're going to dive here in the middle lane. Lich Ullman will not bounce. It just hits once on Beastmaster. He just turns around and says, "Why are you ulti? I ulti." And Beast Monster gets the kill. Dread Ranger lets off another silence. There's no void. There's no silence. TP now coming in. And Beast Master still looking for a kill. Night Stalker on the run out. Gets hit by Cold Arrow. PGG comes in. Shackle Shot lashes Beast Master to a creep. It might be enough damage here from PGG to finish the job. In fact, it is from Void, who from Night Stalker, who comes in and voids. PGG taking up the tower. Dro tries to fire off one shot, but with Windrun, it's impossible to hit the Windrunner. The Gush goes now out. Night Stalker, they can't choose who they want to kill. Windrun's now off cooldown again. So yeah, buyback from Beastmaster.
I think that was a bit overkill. He's not even teleporting. He just bought back pretty late and running.
And he has no ultimate either.
it doesn't make sense, but never mind that. And Broodmother just ran past the tower and now running back around. And she's saving up gold. I don't know what she's going for yet. She has almost 2.5. But we'll see.
So this is what they wanted. And this is the reason for the buyback. It's now daytime, and they want the tier 1 tower in the mid. Beastmaster's the first one in there. But they can't do it because the creep wave got pulled back past the tier 1 tower, and they can't dive that because they're not strong enough yet. So the logic was there, but it caused a couple of issues. PGG. Oh, Shackle. I thought that was going to... Originally, if he popped it as the first thing instead of right-clicking, that could have actually latched Dro Ranger as well as Beastmaster together. That could have been lethal.
That would be a big, big wipe, I think, on the mid lane at least.
Mm-hmm. Well, then again, Lich doesn't have his ultimate. AA's ultimate, well, he does have that, but he's on low life, so he's not going to come in anywhere near. And NS does have his ultimate off cooldown, so that's a possibility.
Yeah, but it is definitely enough with just the Shackle Shot, Power Shot, and AA ulti as well as the Void from Night Stalker. Mm. It's more than an short kill. Top lane is pretty much stale now.
Towards the mid.
It's a
holy schmuck. Oh, it's a holy schmuck.
Holy schmucks?
They want to go in. Lich is there. The Beastmaster Roar is going to be held for the Night Stalker. And there it goes. So Lich is the first one gone. Aeon is going to fly in beautifully right now. And it's on the run back out. And Beastmaster is going to die. Yes, he does. He gets split. But it's going to be also at the cost of an NS as well as Lich. And SK is just like, what's up? I'm here. This could be difficult for the range push. The Tide ulti's still up.
Yeah, he always has to get back on that top lane with Sanking. If he wants to leave it for a long time, then he has to have a TP to get back. Mm-hmm. He's the only one who can stand there right now.
It's like our tier 1 tower on the bottom is gone. Our tier 1 tower on the top lane is trying to be brought down too, but are you also noticing how much money the Broodmother is pulling? It's a lot. It's 3.1k.
He's saving up
3.2.
So high gold. I don't think he's going to buy anything that costs more than 3k in one component, but
unless he hasn't
made up his mind yet.
Unless he goes Radiant. AA ulti in the middle again. Dro's going to be really careful. PGG power shot. Oh, just misses on
Dro. So close.
That hit would have been enough to kill. But it did not latch.
And finally, some heroes are standing on the bottom lane. It feels like they have just forsaken that forever. And
Beastmaster's like, I'm all back. I need farm. I need to catch up with what I did.
And some good scouting going on by Broodmother. He has his broodlings out, so he saw PGG wanting to go up and kill him. But now he knows, and he's just going to be a little bit more passive.
Mm-hmm. That's amazing how many spawns you get. And it's actually going to help out too. This is the big thing about communication when it comes to playing a Broodmother. It's not always just about you creating spiderlings, pushing yourself, getting farm yourself. Things like throwing the spiderlings into a creep camp so Tidehunter can walk up, get a little bit of XP himself from that, or get a little bit of farm himself from that. It's such a big thing as Broodmother not to play. If you are playing in a public game playing as Broodmother, help your teammates out with your spiderlings. Don't just use them and sacrifice them. Now, top lane, the dust will go. They're going to need a Ravage, and they will get the Ravage. There is going to be no Epicenter again. They waited for Vigos to do that, and the
Always
dust of their
dust.
Own. And SK will go down. And maybe even the Night Stalker, there is a tower here, but that insatiable hunger will allow Rice to go back. And yes, you're right, daytime it is. VS will swap out the stun as well, and it might
Windrunner
be enough. Night Stalker goes down, Windrunner cancels the TP, smartly done there by PGG.
Yeah, Rex are coming in as well.
Big
and good fight there. And Tide is very, very good at keeping dust on him at all times that he's ganging on the top lane.
Beastmaster finds Lich.
Wow.
He might even think about the ultimate. Halaterra goes, one last slice.
Hey, he has that haste, so I think Blood Angel was not paying attention to the haste rune and he just died to it. A nice deny by Goblin on the mid tower. That's always nice to catch it tonight, but he needs to get out now. The bench is coming.
SK.
He will die to just orb walk from the bench and draw.
Well, draw is now going to come in. Silence will happen. VS. Halitera goes, the vision remains up. He throws down the ultimate. He was hoping that move will get close enough for that one. And the copy might be enough to kill him. No, it won't. He'll live.
He was doing the right thing. He was just a little bit too quick on the AOLT. If he cut off that bench.
Trouble.
Will Dro die?
No, she's fine. Oh. The power shot of PGG does not have that kind of reach.
Sadly, no. And
Beastmaster smoked. And on the top lane. Does he have his roar up? No, he does not. But 10 seconds and he will. Axis will fly and they harass the SK. Then Burrow strikes back through again. Needs a bite. The Gush needs to come as well. They've already forced the Sandstorm out. And there's the Gush this time. And is he pop a BKB for that?
I don't know, man. I don't know. And the fact that Sanking left his standing there... He was probably just scared of the Axis and the Anchor Smash, but they'd had no dust, so he could have
remained
just
in
tried
the
a little bit more mind game out with a stun. But we see the tower is going to go down mid.
And
they're going for the action. Rek'Sai's there, and he has his ulti ready.
Well, VS is going to kill Lich in the meantime. They're going 1-on-1, support
VS
on support, and VS
yeah.
going to swap and kill. Oh! Beastmaster wanted the action, but VS hogging it all for herself.
It's the war of the supporters, man.
Mm-hmm.
And bottom lane, we see the Dro is just farming up, trying to not be spotted. And Rek'Sai is actually really rich by now. He has 2.7k, so what is he going for? Is he going to go for Blink Dagger, Vanguard? What's he going for?
You'll have to wait and see, man.
On a B?
I love how...
doesn't know. He's
what?
Thinking.
What do you think?
Rek'Sai's thinking. He's thinking about his item choice, man. And he bought something for 1k. Blade mail. So he's going for, like, early Curious, maybe? For the aura strat?
I suppose that'll work.
It's really all about the auras.
The only thing they're missing, though, is the CM aura. If they had that, it would have been a complete trifecta.
The Brute. Oh, she's shackled to her own creep. No!
Oh, that is Spiderling turns against. AOD will kill.
Oh. Evil Spiderling catching that shackle.
It's that one that turns on you, man. There's one in every pack. Web spider. What's a like a? You kind of like a web of spiders. Are spiders like solitary creatures? Is there such a thing as like a multiple spiders?
Cluster of spiders, man.
A cluster? Okay, we'll go with a cluster. There's one in every cluster.
If there are babies, then maybe yeah, cluster of spiders. But granted, that's all another Roshan kill.
It's almost BKB done for Dro too.
Yeah, and Roshan is just so nice. They did lose the top tower, but you can see the gold is still going to keep firmly on the Dire team side.
Buyback and TP. The webs get dropped, spiderlings get created, and the tier 2 tower will take no damage. Aegis the Immortal to under a goal for everybody at the loss of a tier 1 tower and a brute buyback. I'd say that's worth it.
Yeah, indeed.
SK, he's going to finish it, he's going to get stunned before the epic, yes he does! Denial!
Some nice
it is
baiting.
A full-on denial! Even Dro popped the silence.
Yeah, he was not going to throw his ulti there.
Has the SK actually got an ultimate off yet? I think the two in mid. The two in mid.
Oh yeah.
That's the only two he's got off so far. Every other time, he has been stunned, swapped, denied, and that's killing off. VS, but then Beastmaster comes in for a bit of a hand. The roar going to go. The Lich ultimate. Great split off. VS split off to the side. And as we'll go down, Lich is getting completely utterly destroyed. Yes, there is actually a buyback, but will it be enough? Nice to at least get himself down there right now. VS swapping PGG back up again. There goes the Gush. Slow him down. The Courier's flying in with the BKB, so it's done. And it's going to watch
almost
PGG die.
Almost
is
staff.
Gush. Force. Ooh. Away.
He's safe.
They can't catch it. Nice
talker. There, like, I'm here, guys. Go, go, go.
Yeah, he's looking for Beastmaster, but there's no support for him. If he gets silenced, there's going to be no void. There's going to be nothing. He cops a right click from Dro. SK is going to borrow. BKB will pop, and he's going to get the kill on Windrunner. PGG came in too close. Beastmaster on the run back out. Tries to pop the six charges, but gets voided. AOD will get the kill, possibly even a double kill right now. No, it just picks up the Beastmaster. And Drow Ranger TP'd out. I don't think VS going to escape from this. Nightstalk is so fast at nighttime. Lands off the stump, but there's the Burrow Strike. Void and the kill.
Yeah, indeed.
But Brute takes tier 2.
And, someone pointed out that Sand King did get an ulti off when he killed the Aegis on Broodmother. That's true.
That's true, yeah. So three in total.
Actually, Sand King isn't always about getting only your ultis off, but he has been shut down very good this game. Prior to these fights, he was 0-6-1, but now he's gaining a little bit momentum. But top lane is so pushed, Sand King, you need to be there.
Oh, VS, Drow Ranger, trouble, Burrow Strike, Sandstorm, AA ulti. She's going to have to use it.
Can anyone come there?
But Brutus brought down that tier 3 tower down to half. Doesn't matter if anybody's going to come.
They are smoking. They want to go and kill him. It's actually pretty effective. Nah, are they?
Yeah, it's
actually
it's
pretty effective against Brood to just run through all her webs with a smoke active. As soon as you get visible, pop the dust, and you will find him.
Mm-hmm.
It's a pretty good way of finding spiders.
See, smoke is usable. Is like useful for everything.
You smoke them out, yeah.
Yeah. It's like a beehive. How do you deal with the broodmother? Deal with them like bees. That works. Just be careful. Careful of the sting.
Put 5 heroes against him.
That's one way to deal with him. Slight overkill. So just use 5 ultimates. Yeah, that'll kill him. Yeah, that'll work.
That should do it.
Yeah.
And the lion and the Lina ulti.
Mid push now coming out from EXE. Well, the executables. They want to come down here on the middle lane. PGG, the first one down. Going fear not.
And bench finding Lich there might see a rematch on that support battle.
Maybe. I doubt it, though.
I don't think Lich wants it.
It's like,
and
no.
You got a tower down with the Nightstalker.
Yeah, tier 1 on bot. That's nice. That was actually a bit of a thing I was wondering about if we were going to see EXE just move back a little bit further. VS Swap! Right on the ancient apparition against Beastmaster Rod. That was a bit of an overkill on the stuns for it, but it does get the kill nonetheless, so no AA ulti, and no AA for 30 seconds, and he buys back, okay.
And look at the damage done to the tower as soon as they
AA ulti flies in! Epicenter from Vigos, but Ty goes in with a Ravage, and BS with the swap! BKB runs out, PGG could not finish off the kill, and the Legion just bouncing recklessly inside the creep wave.
And meanwhile, top. Look at top lane.
Holy crap, tier 3 tower's going to go. Support's going back. PGG will die to the Beastmaster. Brood is continuing to attack. He is going to get the racks. They can't stop it. Lich is there. So it's like, what are you going to do, Sonny Jim? There is nothing.
He's going to go. He's going to BKB and hit it.
They pop the dust. BKB.
And now he's got it back.
Yeah, he's got to. He's got to. VS is here to swap if he needs to.
He's not going to get it now, but he's so close to dying.
What a swap from VS on that Drow Ranger, though. That was beautiful.
Yeah, really. That was very well done. And look at Rex's gold again. He's up to so high gold. He's going to get his assault cures pretty early. And they have level 4 on, I think, all the auras now. So they have their aura strat up and running. And once you have that, you can push so hard. The damage is ridiculous.
And they're going to add drums to the case as well. Drums is now up for VS. Got it inside his stash flying out.
Wow. That's huge. They're going to be really strong in the next fight. Mm. And along with that, they have the Blink Dagger on Tide, which was so good in the last fight. Blinking in and making a pretty big Tide ulti. Sadly, the Sand King ulti came out first, but it was still very good.
Let's see who wins a battle. Nightstalker or Brood? 1-on-1. Let's go, Sonny Jim. You can't use Hunger when you void it up. But Broodmother's also gone off the initial be. Oh, dust!
Oh,
Rice needs to get out. He needs to get out. He pops the BKB. He's going on AA. He needs it. He's going to get it. The life. He takes it. He steals it all. And it's like, screw this, man. I'm out. I don't want to go for this.
Wow.
And PGG comes up to his aid.
And a lot of them are coming up. And he's going to go. A new dust is flying out.
Shackle doesn't latch, though. And there goes another web. Movement speed is there. Focus firing down. Rice wants the movement speed, but he can't go through. And then Murray Stroke Vigos. If you can't teabag on top, he goes through the rear. And now the bottom lane's also going to be pushed at the same time. Tier 2 tower will take a fall. They can't get back there in time. So many of them went up towards that top lane. Actually, TP scrolls. Windrun doesn't have the mana for it. NS has it. But they might have to let this tier 2 tower go. Oh, SK. I'm seeing SK. Losing life.
Losing life.
Top lane.
And the bot tower is gone as well, so all the tier 2 towers are gone now for the Radiant team.
What was SK doing there?
And they actually threw in a pipe on the Rexxar from nowhere.
So we're thinking about a Selkirass, but then we thought, you know what? That's a really, really bad idea. This is part of the game. Let's get a pipe. Yeah, we're going to use an AA.
Yeah, he was like, he probably realized that they have so much magic damage and pretty much no physical damage. Mm-hmm. So it was the right decision, and they can probably make a key push now. Do they have a mecha on anyone? Lich should have it, I guess.
Checking.
Lich is on the other team, but... They don't have it on anyone. No. Lich should also have it.
Should Lich have a mecha for executable? Nah, it's because he plays good. VS, swap. Mid. Beastmaster Roar, chained off with a stun from VS. This AOL is going to fly in nicely again, hitting on both, but the pipe does pop off from Beastmaster. Doesn't get the effect on the Ventual Spirit, who still is trying to run himself away from the Vortex. And really, Move is moving nicely. Force off up from BGG, but Blink in and Ravage. Axes will fly.
Wow.
PGG fires back in pure rage. How dare you ravage me?
You can't spell ravage without rage, man.
Yeah.
Oh, they might want to go with the cooldown on the Tide ulti. Coming back in the mid lane.
It's possible, though, but they know they've been pushed out too hard. That top lane, Brood has hardly even left it. SK's forced to stay up there. At least SK does have that blink dagger, but then again, so does Tide. The S is coming back down again towards the middle lane. I'm wondering if we will see that mech up sometime soon. We're going to see a Mana Star done pretty soon. Ultimate Orb is already sitting in the courier. He's only 300 gold away from finishing it. Roshan time. Or is it? Did you set your clock?
No, I didn't set it. But it should be back pretty soon because it's pretty long ago that Dro died with.
PJG was just fishing with some shackles because everybody's shackling. Spiderlings just giving a little bit of trouble here to DTS, trying to push themselves up as the illusions then end up just taking the majority of it. As now NS pops off the ultimate, going on the Beastmaster. He does have that roar, and they're trying to bait it out. They're going to bait out the pipe as well. So Beastmaster has managed to pop that off. Broodmother still with the web up, just checking out the middle lane. So Beastmaster holding on to his ultimate for now, but has been forced to pop off that pipe, and that could work out nicely for them if Lich can get a great ultimate off. Or SK.
They're gonna go back though.
Yeah.
But PGG wants to deal one more damage with his power shots.
Every damage counts, man. Make him regen. Make him regen.
Yeah. And again, we see a Sand King running around with a rune. But it's not like Playmate, though, who had all the runes in two games in a row.
Mm-hmm. That does really help an SK move around nicely. You can Sandstorm, you can Burrow Strike, and then you've got the Bolt Rush.
Type, by the way.
Roshan's back. So the Germans, they must have a German clock, or is it a Swiss clock? Swiss clock gives better time. Just watching nice and close.
It's going really quick, and they scout with the ALT, but it's already too late.
You've gone Roshan's robot on me, man. Dead. You've gone robot on me. I'm going to call you back very, very quickly.
Okay.
So we don't have to have a robot. Of course, that does mean because it's the third Roshan, it means we get cheese. So,
all right, I'm back.
Welcome back, and you don't sound like a robot, which is really, really great.
Great.
We have Aegis the Immortal on the Dro Ranger, and we've got Cheese on the Broodmother. Because it's the third one, because Roshan was killed so early.
Yeah, it sounds like it's going to be pretty hard then for the Radiant team, as both those heroes also have BKB to accompany those items. Mm-hmm. And almost a butterfly on Brood.
That's going to be a lot of extra damage coming down. Mana Style is now done. Dro Ranger flew the courier out. Blink has already been used by SK, and he's going to get silenced. The fortifications behind the time. Look at the damage!
Yeah. And she doesn't even have the more Manta. Than Yasha. Yeah, she has like Yasha and BKB. And that damage is ridiculous. But level 16 does so much for Dro Ranger.
Mm-hmm. And it's one of the reasons why she's just such a great economical Agi carry, because every single time you pop your ultimate, you get an extra 15 Agi. It's like giving 1,500 gold for every single level up.
Indeed.
Yeah, the days of, what was it, 33% chance of killing a neutral with every hit?
Yeah, when you had pretty high chance to kill a neutral in one hit. That was awesome, because it worked like a bash that dealt a lot of damage. So if you had lifesteal, you would lifesteal the entire HP that the Greave had remaining. well, in the correct percentage, of course.
Yeah.
So it was actually really effective. And top lane, we see a gang.
Yeah, they're going to get this kill right now. There's nowhere for him to get out.
He has BKB.
Yeah, but that's what the Beastmaster Roar is for. He doesn't pop the BKB just yet. And then the Ravage pops off from Tidy, blinks himself down to keep the support heroes out. And a great VS swap again. Lich Ultimate will bounce up, and there is no creep wave for the Dire. So Tyre's forced to go for the side. Will allow them to live, but PGG is forced to have himself back up to safety, but not for too much safety. And then SK... Oldie's in, but there's just so much resistance. There's so much tankability now. There's a dust revealing off SK, and that'll be the death. Cheese used by Broodmother. And now the push will come, and this should be a barracks down with two heroes gone, and Dro from the side. One hit did so much damage to AA, but he comes around and says, you know what? Yeah, we're here for the barracks. I'll be here for the barracks. I'll kill the barracks.
Yeah, and again, we can see the Aura Strat dealing so much damage. Look at this tower when it's
holy shizer!
And that's DPS that you normally don't see minute 33 in a game, but Aura Strats are very strong.
And now Lich as well as AA try and slow them down. Cold Feet as well as just a little bit of right-click Frost. That's not enough. Just watch our Dread Ranger just right-click down that melee. He turns around and starts going on, hello Shackle, holding Beastmaster in place. He looks a little bit dazed and confused. Now the Beastmaster Roar, AA is gone with so much damage out from the Dro range. I cannot believe this amount of damage. And now the range barracks will take a fall as well. The melee was harder because it had an extra 10 armor, but that's a double raxing. And they'll just rotate bot and finish. And I'm talking about with the creep wave, of course.
Of course. Yeah, well, that's what you can see. If you start losing to an Aura Strat team in the early game, you will get raped in the mid game, and that's basically what's going on now. They can't even stand against this DPS that's coming out from them. Well-executed Aura Strat. This is gonna, of course, it's not over yet, and we have a fight coming up. But it's going to be really hard and panic defense now.
Yeah, I'm waiting for the VS swap and stun.
Yeah, they might even do that. She's picking up some item now.
Mm-hmm. PGG with a fantastic sideline shackle. Aeoli will fly out. This can actually probably stall up the push on the bottom.
Yeah, And the Sanking is ready on top of all. He's ready with his Blink Dagger. He has his ulti. He wants to go in, but they know he's been scouted.
Beastmaster Hawk does wonders.
Indeed.
And now BKB.
And they're going in.
It's popped, and the roar goes off as well. The dust will pop. They want to keep vision here of the Broodmother. Nice Dogger trying to catch up, but that's a long time that BKB will not be back up again because he only has it at 8 seconds now. And Dro Ranger pops her own BKB, wants to go in, right clicks once, and then we go. The VS swapping NS back in again. NS is gone. They've lost their tank ability. And there's a buyback, and SK ult. What the hell is he ulting apart from air? Beastmaster now comes in, and of course that's also why they want to go. The Assault Cuirass is up for this battle, and what a great Ravage. Lich Ultimate will go in nicely around EXE, but they've got so much life. They will live in PGG. They're trying to kill off Drone Ranger, whose Aegis Immortal will now pop, but popped off the Mana Star to help out with that. PGG will try and TP out, but VS with the last stun will finish the job. That is GG.
Yeah.
And there's the disconnect. There's not even a GG call. Was that a GG call? I don't know if that is Russian. Very, very good game. I appreciate you playing.
Yeah, but it's the Observers, so...
Was it the Observers?
Yeah, it doesn't really matter if the Observers called a GG. But, we will see the throne go down, and so quickly. And GG comes out from PGG as well as Rice.exe. Mm-hmm.
And of course, that is our last game for the day as well. Thank you very much for tuning in, everybody, to all the action today. If you want to check out any of the VODs from the games which happened today, you can do so. They'll be uploaded in, well, over the next few hours, and will be available over at joindota.com. You can see the Own3D TV ones there, but we also have a YouTube channel, /joindota. You can check that out if you want to keep up to date with everything coming up. As far as everything Dota 2, we keep our news section very up to date. You can check it out at joindota.com, or also keep up to date with the Facebook updates. We put them up with every single news article we do. That really, I think that's the end of my pimpage. I would like to thank Waga, man. Thanks for joining me again.
Yeah, it's been great fun to cast with you. And, wow, we've seen some pretty good games today. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, nice day.
It's been
a
good day.
See you all who have been watching. Now we see the blue wall of disconnects.
Luckily, I hide that from everybody else when it happens. As far as something which I will not hide from you, I want to check out right now my own website. Yeah, to see what matches are up tomorrow. So tomorrow, our first game of the day will be Na'Vi versus Mousesports. That should be some fun.
That should be a great game.
That'll be coming up at 19 CET, so 7 p.m. We'll then follow up with the old team Shakira, now known as Western Wolves, going up against J4T. That should also be one hell of a game. They're both the defense matches. And then, and only then, will we jump in. Well, actually, we might jump in beforehand because there's an hour gap between those two matches. So we might try and find a D2E game in the middle of it all and then catch on to the last D2E game of the night. So we should still have four more games here tomorrow night on the live stream. In the meantime, though, I wish everybody a very good time. Remember, eat, keep your fluids up, and keep playing Dota. We'll see you all tomorrow.
Goodbye.